LUCIFERINISM. In order to be able to realize that the WRM is a continuation of the heavenly revolution, we must understand Lucifer, what Lucifer did in heaven, and why, before he and or Satan caused our first parents to defect from God, being the highest, brightest, and most intelligent of God's creatures, he also had a free will. He could will to remain loyal, faithful, and obedient to God, and accept God, Adonai, as the supreme authority over the entire universe, or he could challenge that, right? Lucifer, in heaven, was next to God. He was intelligent, therefore it is obvious that he could not have envied him. Saint Thomas said, "Only a fool can be envious of what is so far above him as to be impossible of attainment." Lucifer is no fool. Lucifer's pride in his angelic attributes, i.e., office, character, and personality could have caused him to desire to be in his own order as God is in the divine order. In other words, Lucifer's pride in his own perfections could have made him wish to become the ruler of his own order rather than remain subject to God, regardless of the exalted state to which he had been elevated by God. This line of reasoning does not infer that Lucifer was fool enough to wish to dethrone God. He simply wished to rule a section of the universe in his own right. Today many human beings suffer from the same kind of inflated ego. It could be termed an overwhelming desire for absolute independence or self-sufficiency. Saint Thomas, Scotus, and Suarez agree that the sin Lucifer committed was the sin of pride, but they disagree with each other on exactly what constituted his sin of pride. My studies have convinced me that Lucifer's sin of pride consisted of his determination to break from God and set up his own dynasty. I am supported in my conviction by biblical authority and history. Lucifer got what he wanted by leading the heavenly revolt. He persuaded vast multitudes of various levels of the angels to join him. Among these were one-third of the highest, the brightest, and the most intelligent of the heavenly host. Lucifer got himself expelled from heaven and cast into hell, and this was exactly what he wanted to have happen. Since then he has struggled to wean as many others away from God as possible, so that they may come under his dominion. We know of his activities only on this earth, and we call this the World Revolutionary Movement. My purpose in writing my last three books, I doubt if I shall be granted time to write others, has been to shed light on the WRM and the SOS, a subject of such great importance that it affects the life of every human being and his or her immortal soul. Many priests and ministers have told me of their appreciation of my motives. On the other hand, there are priests and ministers who, when asked by their parishioners to express an opinion on the hidden chapters of biblical and secular history as exposed and explained in Pawns in the Game and Red Fog over America, have said, "What he writes borders on heresy." What they don't mention is the great truth expounded by the greatest theologians and philosophers of the Church of Christ, i.e., all truth borders on heresy. What really matters is that, when expounding the truth, we don't step over the borderline as defined in the scriptures. When ministers and or priests close the door to a mind seeking further knowledge of the truth, they serve the devil's purpose. Isaiah 28:7, Micah 3:11, Mal 2:7. A Presbyterian minister in Ottawa said my writings were unmitigated nonsense. A minister in Owen Sound published a pamphlet stating that I was anti-Semitic and spreading modern heresy. These men and several others, both Gentiles and Jews, have done their best to involve me in arguments and litigation. They probably intended, by so doing, to use up my time to such an extent that they would seriously interfere with my determination to throw as much light as I can on this subject before my own light has gone out. In case readers run into this kind of criticism, I wish to remind them that the knowledge of ministers and priests is subject to the restrictions placed on them by the curricula laid down by those who control the seminaries of a particular faith. My studies, over a period of 40 years, have never ceased. I have never allowed my mind to be subjected to limitations. This is the way I believe that God intended it should be. What I write, I believe to be the truth. Readers should consider the hidden facts of history as detailed in my writings, to form their own opinions and reach their own decisions. The curricula in many seminaries are seriously restricted for the simple reason that even theologians of the same faiths have been, and still are, openly divided in opinion on many matters dealing with the fall of angels. However, both Scotus and Suarez agree that none of the angels, including Lucifer, ever repented their defection from God. Both agree that repentance was a possibility to them, and that God gave them the time and opportunity for repentance, but during the interval of time Lucifer and his followers committed other sins. With these opinions, St. Thomas disagrees. It is nothing to be amazed at when theologians and philosophers disagree. Only God and the devil know on whose side they are. Matt 7:15 warns us of false prophets in sheep's clothing. Even as far back as Jeremiah's day, priests were being denounced because of their unfaithfulness. Jer 1:18. Many priests and ministers today teach because they are hired. They teach what those who hire them say they must teach. Mel 2:8. The word, page 24, Satan, prince of this world, hire, used in this regard can mean more than to obtain pay for services. It can mean to render service and give unlimited obedience to an earthly power in the hope of obtaining earthly and supernatural rewards. When, as staff training officer for the Canadian Naval Reserve Division 1943-4, I lectured to the officers and men on the subject of discipline and obedience, I shocked some of the divisional commanding officers by telling their subordinates that no officer or man was required to obey an order that is contrary to the commandments of God, i.e., natural law or the dignity of man. Many of the most horrible atrocities committed in the name of God against the human race by Satanists were committed by innocent men carrying out orders. How very convenient! If subordinates are required to obey all orders, then all the SOS, who control all those in high places, need to see that orders are given to do things that serve the devil's purpose. Christians in holy orders should never forget that regardless of any consideration, including the oath of obedience they give to superior authority, their first allegiance, like that of a soldier or sailor, is to God. No oath can bind them to commit sin. Keeping silence, or failure to tell the whole truth regarding the WRM, is a sin against God and a crime against God's creatures. Tell the truth and shame, confound the devil, should be the motto of every militant Christian. This truth was repeatedly emphasized by the late Pope Pius XII, when he told parish priests they are responsible for the secular as well as the spiritual welfare of their congregations, and should guide the members of their flocks on social, economic and political matters. He showed his will in this regard when, in 1957, he asked all faithful Catholics to pray for the silent church. The word church, as he used it, means the whole body of Christian believers, the ecclesiastical organization or power as distinguished from the state. Don't let anyone tell you differently. If they do, they lie. If they lie, they serve the devil's cause. The Luciferian conspiracy could not have developed since our Lord died, to its semi-final stage if those who have pretended to be Christian clergy, dedicated to God, had not sinned against him by maintaining silence on this all-important subject. Let me remind my readers that no ecclesiastical authority, Catholic or non-Catholic, has challenged the truth of what I say on this subject. Hundreds of ordained priests and ministers have admitted that I have convinced them of the truth. The majority of them excused themselves from helping me openly by saying, I am under discipline. I am afraid God does not accept that as a valid excuse. God dispense with all forms of compulsory discipline. Under God's plan for the rule of the universe, we are free to love and serve Him of our own will, or go to hell in our own way. It is time we stopped making excuses and proceeded to prove to God that we wish to love and serve Him for eternity. 11. I feel justified in making one further remark to protect my readers from those who slander me and my work. In addition to being mentally restricted by the curriculum of their schools and colleges, those who slander me were brought up in an atmosphere of social security. In the majority of cases, their education, or indoctrination, was paid for by multimillionaires who set up so-called charitable foundations so they could dictate the curricula of the educational institutions which they endowed. It has been proved that these millionaires belong to the international financial cartels who have financed both sides in every war and revolution fought in the last 200 years. It is logical to assume that this being the case, the curricula of the educational institutions they endow are not directed to making God's truth known, but to limiting knowledge regarding the truth, so that the Luciferian conspiracy can be developed to its final objectives. My slanderers have never had to worry about where their next meal came from. They have been babied along and encouraged to develop an inflated ego regarding their knowledge and importance. They may have suffered a few hardships, but they always knew they would be looked after provided they remained obedient to those their benefactors placed over them. My life has been entirely different. Due to a serious accident, my father died in his 40s. At the age of 13, I was left to shift for myself. When 15, I was at sea, working an average of 12 hours a day. I rose to be a master mariner and a commander in the Canadian Navy. I have written enough since to have had 10 books of nonfiction published and incorporated in reference libraries throughout the world. I did all this by the grace of God and my application to a dedicated cause. I was determined to find out, if possible, why human beings can't live in peace. It is only fair to mention that I rejected offers of fame and fortune, because such offers always had strings attached which would have prevented me continuing to see after, and publish, the truth. The only thing I ask from God is that He permit me to live long enough to pass on what I have learned about the WR.M to others. While my traducers slept in warm beds and lived in comfort and security, carefully guarded from danger, I battled my way on the stormy seas and lived a life which brought me in intimate contact with all that is evil. I became intimately associated with Bolsheviks, nihilists, and Nazi proselytes. But, notwithstanding that, I wanted to help the underdog, and had the urge to be a do-gooder. By the grace of God, I never was convinced that by joining any so-called reform organization, I would be doing the will of God. It is beyond my comprehension how the hierarchy of many religions embrace men who have worked openly in the WRM for, page 25, Satan, prince of this world. Because of its very nature, the Luciferian revolt must of necessity be designed to bring about the destruction of all other forms of government and religion, so that, in the final stage of the conspiracy, the Luciferian ideology may be imposed on what is left of the human race by satanic despotism. Today we term this totalitarian dictatorship. Obviously, it is much easier for a small but powerful group to subjugate one person, one group, one organization, one government, or one religion, than it is to subjugate dozens and even hundreds of individuals. Therefore, the synagogue of Satan introduced internationalism. The late William Lyon Mackenzie King, Prime Minister of Canada for nearly a quarter of the 20th century, sold the Rockefeller family on this idea early in the 1900s, when he was Labour Minister in the Canadian government. Just as Albert Pike worked secretly to bring about a one-world government, and the one-world religion, Luciferianism, so did Mackenzie King. He specialized in bringing organized labor under control of the international authority, because if those placed in control at the top are agent or of the synagogue of Satan, organized labor could be used to foment wars and revolutions leading to the destruction of governments and religions. Then, after organized labor had been used to stir up strife between capital and labor and cause economic chaos and turmoil, it could in turn be subjugated in the final stage of the conspiracy. Obviously, an international organization controlled at the top by the secret agents of the synagogue of Satan can be more easily controlled than can hundreds of independent unions and guilds. Does any thinking person believe that the thugs, ex-convicts, and university graduates in economics who control organized labor at the top are not agent or of the Illuminati, otherwise known as the synagogue of Satan? If this were true, why are those in control trying to make it compulsory for all workers to join unions? The same principle as Mackenzie King used in organized labor is used by those who direct the WRM at the top to obtain control of all other fields of human endeavor, including the sciences, professions, politics, business, industry, governments, and religions. Thus we see that, previous to the organization of the League of Nations, after World War I ended, the policy of those who directed the WRM at the top had been to split up and destroy all powerful governments, religions, industrial, financial, capitalistic, and labor organizations, etc., in order that out of the resulting chaos, those affected would gradually accept the idea of internationalism. World War II was fomented and fought to further soften up nationalism and rugged individualism. The United Nations organization was set up on land provided by the Rockefellers, by whom Mackenzie King was employed 1914-1919. The UN is intended to give an air of respectability to internationalism which communism and Nazism had brought into disrepute. The synagogue of Satan control the United Nations as they controlled the League of Nations. Looking back, we can see how this secret power has controlled every strong and powerful group, organization, movement, and government from behind the scenes, by means of specialists, experts, and advisors, whom they trained and placed in key positions, by using the power and influence their control of gold gave them. Every development of the Luciferian conspiracy led to the stage in which the world finds itself today. Its progress can be traced back to the days when Christ told us bluntly and plainly that the synagogue of Satan controlled all those in high places. Christ spoke the truth. But he did not say, nor did he imply, that all those in high places realized they were controlled by the synagogue of Satan. It is for this reason that Christ showed us by the nature, manner, and place of his birth, by his early life of subjection to the lawful and parental authority, by the way he chose his apostles, humble working men, and by his teachings during the last 3 years of his life, that if we wish to break free from the bonds with which we are bound more and more strongly every day by the synagogue of Satan, we must start at the very bottom, at the grassroots, to make known the truth concerning the continued existence of the Luciferian conspiracy to all nations, as quickly as is possible. It is the perfect wisdom of Christ which justifies Christians' belief in Him as the Son of God. The fact that Christians don't accept the truth He taught and follow His advice illustrates exactly how clever, cunning, and unscrupulous are those devils incarnate who, inspired by Lucifer, comprise the synagogue of Satan, SOS. Only the SOS, supernaturally inspired, could have prevented the human race from putting God's plan for the rule of creation into effect upon this earth. Instead, we have allowed those who direct the WRM at the top to further the secret plans and diabolical ambitions of the high priests of the Luciferian creed. Years simply because they profess to have had a change of heart and mind. They lionize these men and make them professors in universities. But, to my knowledge, not one of them has shed any light on the secret power they must know is behind the various subversive movements which make up the WR.M. If Mazzini felt that secret control, surely they must have felt it also. But if they do, they never say. I do not name my traducers because I don't think it charitable to do so. However, I feel confident that this book will be brought to their attention by some of my readers. Then, if they have any sense, they will accept the truth and square themselves with God. Page 26. Satan, Prince of this world, Christ gave us the Lord's Prayer so that, by repeating it daily, we would have the above truths impressed upon our minds. It must be obvious that if we did establish God's kingdom here on earth, His will would be done here as it is in heaven. When Christ told those who persecuted Him, "My kingdom is not of this world," He did not say, nor did He imply, that it wasn't our duty to introduce God's plans for the rule of the universe into our own forms of government. God's plan requires that religious leaders, truly God's men, should advise our temporal rulers, and prevent them straying from the true and narrow path. That is the relationship God intended should exist between church and state. Instead of holy men, we have allowed the SOS to place evil men in control of all those in high places. Our earth is a very small potato when compared with the galaxies of heavenly bodies, the suns, stars, and planets which make up the universe. The Holy Scriptures tell us that the universe is now split into two parts. One part is heaven, reserved for those who prove they wish to love and serve God voluntarily for all eternity. The other part is hell, reserved for those who defect from God. Revelations tell us exactly how and when this division will be made definite and final. Then there will be only heaven and hell, and they will last for all eternity. It must be obvious to all thinking people that the reason Christ told us we must start at the bottom and work up, using men and women whose minds have not been brought under control of the synagogue of Satan, by propaganda introduced into our seats of learning and all other channels of public information, is because He knew that all those in high places don't realize they are being controlled by the agent Yurov, the synagogue of Satan. However, the devil's agents keep the human race so busily engaged scratching for a living, or seeking riches and carnal pleasures, that the vast majority never have time for prayer and meditation. Our leaders, secular and religious, never seem to have time to consider anything other than worldly problems, and the devil's agents see they are busy with problems which concern the world and the flesh to the exclusion of all spiritual interest and values. But because the vast majority of those who occupy the high places are elected by the people, it is logical to say that until the people are subjugated, it is possible for an enlightened and fully informed public to create such a force of public opinion, that such force could seriously affect even those who occupy the very highest places in politics, government, economics, industry, the sciences, and religion. In my humble opinion, That is what Christ meant when he told us to go and teach the truth to all people of all nations. Christ made us the promise that if we did so, the truth would set us free. These are the reasons that those who direct the Luciferian conspiracy at the top keep their true intentions to enslave the people physically, mentally, and spiritually secret. They deliberately surround the truth with a thick fog of lies, which we term propaganda. While dealing with this phase of the WRM, it is essential to prove that the synagogue of Satan does not permit even those they select to direct the WRM to suspect they are being used as tools to bring the Luciferian conspiracy nearer to its final goal. Seppi, sometimes referred to as Giuseppe of Joseph Mazzini, has been represented to the people by the controlled press as a great Italian patriot, as were Mackenzie King of Canada and General Albert Pike of the USA, and many others since proved to be hypocrites. These men pretended to serve God, their country and humanity, while in reality they knowingly furthered the secret Luciferian plans. Documentary evidence definitely proves that from 1834 until he died in 1872, Mazzini directed the WRM throughout the world he used as revolutionary headquarters. The Lodges of the Grand Orient, established towards the end of the 18th century by Weishaupt, and the councils of Pike's New and Reformed Polity and Right, established the second half of the 19th century in all countries throughout the world. Mazzini was closely associated with one Dr. Bridenstine. After Mazzini's death in 1872, a letter he had written to Bridenstine came to light. The contents fully illustrate what I mean when I say that not even the directors of the WRM are permitted to know they further the secret plans of the Luciferian conspiracy, unless they have convinced those who constitute the synagogue of Satan that they have finally and completely defected from God and are suitable and ready for initiation into the full or final secret study of Mazzini's secret life. Proves that he actually accepted Satan as prince of the world. He worshipped him as such. As director of the WRM, he was admitted into the synagogue of Satan, and yet, even as a member of that group, his letter to Bridenstine shows that he had not been initiated into the full secret, which is that Lucifer is God, the equal of Adonai, our God, and that the ultimate purpose of the WRM is to bring about one form or another of a one-world government, the powers of which the high priests of the Luciferian creed intend to usurp so they can then impose a Luciferian totalitarian dictatorship upon the people of this world. In the letter referred to, Mazzini wrote, "We form an association of brothers in all parts of the globe. We wish to break every yoke. Yet there is one that is unseen, that can hardly be felt, yet that weighs on us. Whence comes it? Where is it? No one knows, or at least no one tells. This association is secret even to us, the veterans of secret societies." Page 27. Satan, prince of this world. The fact that the full secret is known only to a very few people is of the greatest importance. It means that as long as there is still time to make the truth known, I prove this statement to be true by making known to communist leaders in Canada in 1956 the fact that, according to Pike's plan for the final stage of the Luciferian conspiracy, communism is to be made to destroy itself, together with Christianity and the greatest social cataclysm the world has ever known, to be provoked for that specific purpose by those who direct the Luciferian conspiracy at the top. This information caused the biggest split in the Communist International that has happened since Lenin usurped power on behalf of the Illuminati in 1917. During 1956-1957, the split in the Communist Party made headlines in the newspapers of the world, and explained why Molotov, Malenkov, and others were ousted. The same information has been made known to religious leaders of most Christian denominations, But so facts as we know, they still refuse to accept the warnings as the truth. When Mazzini died in 1872, Pike selected Adriano Lemmy, another alleged Italian patriot, to succeed him as director of the WRM. He also was a confirmed Satanist. Pike had established the supervising or directing council of the political action section of the WRM in Rome before Mazzini died. When Pike made his selection, a strange situation developed. Lemmy was such a confirmed Satanist that he insisted that all members of Pike's new and reformed Palladian rite worship Satan as Prince of this world, and as their god. He went so far as to have his friend, Brother Carducci, compose a hymn to his satanic majesty entitled, The Godial Mirror, which, to the great annoyance of Pike, Lemmy ordered to be sung at all Palladian rite banquets. This situation developed to the stage when Pike, to end the matter once and for all time, issued a letter of dot instruction. Pike, speaking as sovereign pontiff of the Luciferian creed, made this very profound, and from the Christian viewpoint, profane, pronouncement. He addressed it to the heads of the 26 councils of his, Pike's new and reformed Palladian rite, established all over the five continents as the secret headquarters of those he had selected to direct all aspects and phases of the WRM, so that communism, Nazism, nihilism, and every other enemy of God and of his creatures could be used to further the secret plans of those who directed the Luciferian conspiracy. At the top, Pike's letter reads in part, we quote a translation of it, taken from page 587 of A.C. Derive's book dealing with this subject, La Femme et l'Enfant en la France Machinerie Universelle. That which we must say to the crowd is, we worship God. But it is the God that one worships without superstition. The Masonic religion should be, by all of us initiates of the high degrees, maintained in the purity of the Luciferian doctrine. If Lucifer were not God, would Adonai, whose deeds prove his cruelty, perfidy and hatred of men, barbarism, and propulsion for science, would Adonai and his priests calumniate him? Yes, Lucifer is God. And, unfortunately, Adonai is also God. For the eternal law is that there is no light without shade, no beauty without ugliness, no white without black. For the absolute can only exist as two gods. Thus the doctrine of Satanism is a heresy, emphasis added, and the true and pure philosophical religion is the belief in Lucifer, the equal of Adonai. But Lucifer, God of light and God of good, is struggling for humanity against Adonai, the God of darkness and evil. We wish to point out that Pike's letter, from which the above quotation has been taken, was translated into French by Derive, and then translated back into English. Because I have studied this matter from many angles, I believe the word crowd should have been translated as goyim or masses. I also believe the translator used the words Masonic religion when he should have said the religion as practiced in the lodges of the Grand Orient and the councils of the new and reformed Palladian rite. By using the word Masonic, one may be misled, because study of contemporary literature of that time proves that the head of British Masonry had warned the Grand Masters of English Masonic lodges that they, and their members, were not, under any pretext or circumstance, to affiliate with, or associate with Grand Orient Masons, much less Pike's new and reformed Palladian rite. Dom Paul Benoit, recognized as an authority on this subject, and author of La Cité Antichristienne, two parts, and La France Machinerie, two volumes, says on page 449 FF volume I of FM, the Reformed Palladian rite has a fundamental practice and purpose, the adoration of Lucifer. It is full of all the impieties and all the infamies of black magic. Having been established in the United States by Pike, it has invaded Europe, and each year it is making terrifying progress. All its ceremonial is full of blasphemies against God and against our Lord Jesus Christ, such as the guile, the cunning and deceit of those who direct the Luciferian conspiracy, that they not only tolerate, but encourage Satanism in a one but the highest degrees. They direct their agent Ur to place the idea in the public's mind that Freemasonry, Judaism, Roman Catholicism, Communism, Nazism and any or all other organizations with international objectives are secretly directing the WRM, while all the time documentary evidence and the events of history prove that the synagogue of Satan, controlled at the top by the high priests of the Luciferian creed, use any and all of the movements whenever it is possible to further their own diabolical secret plans and ambitions. Lemme, when head of Grand Orient Masonry in Italy and France, also belonged to Pike's new and reformed Paludan rite. Before he was initiated into the full secret by Pike, Lemme tried to bring about the destruction of the Vatican by his anti-clerical campaigns. Page 28. Satan, Prince of this World. After his initiation, which is said to have been conducted personally by Pike, his attitude and activities suddenly changed. While he outwardly remained anti-clerical and anti-Vatican, he no longer advocated the violent overthrow of the Vatican by force. Pike did with Lemme what Karl Rothschild had had to do little more than a decade earlier with other Satanists, when they stirred up so much anti-Vatican hatred that the governments of France and Italy were on the verge of destroying it. Karl Rothschild, an initiate of the full secret, stepped in to act as peacemaker between the Vatican and her enemies. History relates how his intervention saved the Vatican and made Karl Rothschild the friend and trusted advisor of the Pope. He reorganized the affairs of the Treasury and State Departments. But history has proved that Karl Rothschild was no true friend of the Vatican. Two world wars, instigated by his family of money lenders and their international affiliate who direct the WRM, have seen Christians of all denominations divided into opposing camps, been made to fight and kill each other off by the tens of millions. This has been done to bring Pike's plan for the final social cataclysm nearer to fruition. Communism grew stronger as Christianity was weakened, until today, as Pike's plan required, communism has darkened the entire earth. While it would be inaccurate to deny that there have been bad popes, as there have been bad kings, it is only proper to point out that the bad popes and kings were no worse than some of the other leaders of Christianity when they became presidents of republics. Luciferianism demands that all temporal and spiritual authority be destroyed because of their alleged badness. Because the struggle in which we are involved is against the spiritual forces of darkness, it stands to reason that there must be good and bad people in all walks of life, in all levels of government and in all religions. It is typical of all who serve the devil's cause that they always use destructive criticism aimed at those in authority to undermine the confidence and loyalty of the individual in the remaining governmental and religious institutions. This policy helps those who direct the WRM to at first weaken, and then destroy all remaining governments and religions. Let us never forget that there is nothing wrong with Christianity. Many things done in the name of Christianity were done by men who, knowingly or unknowingly, furthered the secret plans of the Luciferian conspiracy. What we need to do is clean upon and strengthen Christianity as God would wish. The above remarks are published to explain how it is that Satanists have always attacked the popes and the Vatican, and advocated their destruction, while the high priests of the Luciferian creed have, to date, always stepped in and prevented their doing so. the intervention of those who control the synagogue of Satan at the top was not out of love or respect for the Pope of the Vatican. They intervened because, being initiated into the full secret, they knew that when their conspiracy reaches its final stage, after all temporal powers have been reduced in strength until they no longer remain world powers, when a tired and weary people have been reduced to such a physical and mental condition that they became convinced that only a one-world governorment can put an end to revolutions and wars, and give them peace, they must use the clash between communism and Christianity to destroy all remaining religious institutions also. General Albert Pike revealed how this was to be done in the letter he wrote Mazzini August 15, 1871. That part which deals with this particular phase of the conspiracy reads as follows: "We shall unleash the nihilists and atheists, and we shall provoke a formidable social cataclysm which in all its horror will show clearly to the nations, people of different nationalities, the effects of absolute atheism, origin of savagery and of the most bloody turmoil. Then everywhere, the citizens obliged to defend themselves against the world minority or revolutionaries, will exterminate those destroyers of civilization, and the multitude, disillusioned with Christianity, whose deistic spirits will be from that moment without compass, direction, anxious for an ideal, but without knowing where to render its adoration, will receive the true light, through the universal manifestation of the pure doctrine of Lucifer, brought finally out in the public view, a manifestation which will result from the general reactionary movement which will follow the destruction of Christianity and atheism, both conquered and exterminated at the same time." We ask the reader to study every word of this diabolically inspired document. According to Pike's military blueprint, drawn up between 1859 and 1871, three global wars and three major revolutions were to place the high priests of the Luciferian creed in position to usurp world powers. Two world wars have been fought according to schedule. The Russian and Chinese revolutions have achieved success. Communism has been built up in strength and Christendom weakened. World War III is now in the making. If it is allowed to break out, all remaining nations will be further weakened, and Islam and political Zionism will be destroyed as world powers. The reader must not forget that the Arab world is made up of millions of people, many of whom are Christians, many are of the Jewish faith, many are Mohammedans, but all subscribe to belief in the same God Christians worship as the creator of the universe. The Quran of the Mohammedan faith is practically identical with the Bible, excepting only that the Mohammedan religion, while accepting Jesus Christ as the greatest of God's prophets before Muhammad, does not permit its members to believe in the divinity of Christ. The point we wish to make is this: those who direct the Luciferian conspiracy at the top realize only too well that before they can provoke the final social cataclysm, they must first of all bring about the destruction of Islam as a world power, because if Islam were not destroyed, it would undoubtedly line up with Christianity. Page 29. Satan, prince of this world, in the event of an all-out war with communism. If that were allowed to happen, the balance of power would be held by Christianity, allied to Mohammedanism, and it would be very unlikely that both sides would conquer and exterminate each other. It is of the greatest of importance that these facts, which explain the political intrigue and chicanery now going on in the Near, Middle, and Far East, be brought to the attention of ALL political and religious leaders so they may take action to prevent the last phases of the Luciferian conspiracy from being put into effect, and bring to fruition the prediction made in chapter 20 of Revelations, i.e., that Satan shall be bound for 1,000 years. The events of the past half century would indicate that we are rapidly approaching that period of the world's history when, if it were not for the intervention of God, No flesh would survive. Matt 24:22, Mark 13:20. It is important that the general public know their diabolical fate being prepared for the whole of the human race. I cannot agree with some of the clergy of several denominations, with whom I have discussed this matter at considerable length, who say it is better that the public be left in ignorance of their pending fate. To tell them the truth will only alarm them and cause them to panic. Even some bishops, who are supposed to be the shepherds of their flocks, hold such views. This is beyond my comprehension. They are like physicians who advocate drugging a person they suppose to be dying at the first indication of pain. If the general public is told the whole truth, knowledge of the truth will certainly make the vast majority of people busy themselves about saving their immortal souls. Knowledge of the truth regarding the diabolically inspired conspiracy will wake them up. It will put an end to lethargy and indifference. As Christ told us, the truth will set us free, spiritually, from the bonds with which we are being ever tighter bound, by the spiritual forces of darkness every day. What does it matter if devils incarnate kill our bodies, provided we prevent them deceiving us into losing our immortal souls? Matt 10:28, Luke 12:4. The truth is that if World War III is fought, the United States will be the only remaining world power after it is ended. Either all people will have to acknowledge that power, or they will clamor for and demand a world government. And they will get it if the Luciferian conspiracy is allowed to be developed to its intended conclusion. Then, through the auspices of the United Nations, or some similar organization, a puppet king will be made world sovereign, and he will secretly be under the influence and direction of the agent or of the synagogue of Satan, who will have been appointed, not elected, to be his specialists, experts, and advisors. The high priests of the Luciferian creed know they cannot usurp world power before the United States is ruined as the last remaining world power, so those who direct the WRMATTHEVERYTOP are arranging matters so the United States will, as Lenin stated, fall into our hands like an overripe fruit. This is how events taking place today indicate the subjugation of the USA is planned. Pike's plan requires that the final social cataclysm between the masses controlled by atheistic communism and those who profess Christianity be fought on a national as well as an international scale. That is the reason, and the only reason, that communism is being tolerated, while being kept under restraint, in the remaining so-called free nations of the world. I have served in the higher levels of government, and in the naval forces, in positions that enabled me to realize that communism in Canada and in the United States is tolerated, and is being controlled and contained, so its evil destructive force can be used on the national level, as well as the international level, when the final social cataclysm is provoked by those who direct the WRM. At the top, I have tried to bring this great truth to the attention of cabinet ministers since 1944, when I served on the staff of Naval Headquarters in Ottawa. The late Right Hon. Angus MacDonald was then Naval Secretary. Admiral J.C. Jones was Chief of Naval Staff. I convinced both these chief executives regarding the truth of what was going on behind the scenes of government in Canada and the United States. I was ordered to submit these facts in the form of briefs, so they could be presented to the Canadian cabinet. I know these matters were presented to said cabinet, but Mackenzie King brushed them aside. Carl Ralston, Minister for the Army, and Major Chubby Power, Minister for the Air Force, were so disgusted with Mackenzie King because of the manner in which he wielded autocratic power, that they both resigned from his government, even though it was wartime. The Naval Minister told me personally, "Carr, The cabinet is full of the people you wish to expose. I intend to stick with the ship, Navy until we win the war. Then I am going to resign from federal politics. What is going on is more than I can take. When I requested to be demobilized in May, 1945, after Germany collapsed, in order that I might start riding pawns in the game and red fog over America, Admiral Jones shook my hand as we said goodbye, and said, I wish you luck with your new books. Publication of the truth, as you have explained it to the minister and myself, could do more to prevent World War III than any defensive plan based on armaments. Both of these men died suddenly shortly afterwards. In 1955 it required six times as many members of the RC.M.P. and the FBI to contain communism in Canada and the United States, as it did in 1945. In 1956, the Canadian Minister of Justice asked Parliament to increase his budget by millions of dollars on the grounds that 6 RC.M.P. officers were now required to keep check on communists, where only one was required 10 years before. This was a superlative illustration of the page 30 Satan, Prince of this World double talk used by men who are involved in the WRM. The minister said, to keep check on communists. What he should have said was, to keep communism in check until the time is ripe to use it. I personally knew Inspector John Leopold, who for many years headed the anti-subversive department of the RC.M.P. We discussed these matters on many occasions. The RC.M.P. and the FBI could arrest every communist in Canada and the United States within 24 hours of the order being given by the heads of the respective departments of justice, provided the communists were not tipped off previously. It isn't much of an exaggeration to say that John Leopold had one of his agents sleep with the communist leaders every night. But the order to destroy the most destructive weapon the leaders of the Luciferian conspiracy possess, by legal means, was not given, and John Leopold retired from the RC.M.P, a broken man, worn out bodily, mentally, and, I am sorry to say, spiritually, because of sheer frustration. The power of the United States can be destroyed only from within. The internal unrest now being fomented between citizens of different races, colors, and creeds is not so much the result of aggressive action taken by different groups as it is the result of rulings which have been passed by the Supreme Court. Their purpose was the creation of issues and troubles where previously no real issue or problem existed. I say with all gravity, fully realizing the seriousness of what I say, that if the day is allowed to come when those controlled by atheistic communism are thrown at the throats of those who profess Christianity, on an international scale, over some real or cooked up issue, then communists in every one of the remaining so-called free nations will be released from the check reins with which they are now being contained, and, as Pike boasted to Mazzini, the people will experience the worst social cataclysm the world has ever known. What I say is based on documentary evidence supported by historical facts, events which have taken place since the plans were laid. Everything Weishaupt planned between 1770 and 1776 to further the Luciferian conspiracy has developed exactly as he intended. Everything Pike planned between 1859 and 1871 has occurred exactly as he intended. We are now on the verge of World War III, and about to enter the first stage of the conspiracy. But what is of even greater importance? The Holy Scriptures confirm what I say. All a person needs to do, to convince himself of this truth, is to read Matt 24:1-35 and Mark 13:1-30 and Luke 21:25-33. What abominations could the human mind conceive worse than those we know from experience happen when human beings fight civil wars? What could be worse than to use the atomic weapons and nerve gas? It seems that human beings are turned into devils incarnate when engaged in war, particularly civil war, because they practice every abomination upon each other that Dante in his Inferno describes as being practiced in hell. Page 31. Satan, prince of this world,